Hey guys, JC6 here. Back with you with Penis Wright Trials and Tribulations. Hey, let me check the volume. Okay, I gotta close my door too. Yeah, finally got a job. That's my good news. Finally, right now I'm working as a cleaner because of the hurricane. I'm working as a cleanup houses. Let's see, I don't know nothing about no murder. But let me... Are you sure about that? We talked about 1 month ago, you know? See these teeth? That's how sharp my secretary is. Sharp? Is it talking about Violet Catalyst? That ring, she has everything in my scheduler. Simple, mainly in the office. That's where it sits, that's where I was. Seems like a rather sketchy schedule. There it goes again. And what the tiger did all the simple isn't the issue. What's important is what he was doing on the day of the murder, so now what? Press harder. This tiger, what you use one? If you wouldn't mind going into a bit more detail. It's a day in train, you know it. Remember the rules. No, it's the center that we established to witness the alibi accurately. I agree. The victim was killed on December 3rd. Were you in the office that day too? Maybe you ain't listening. Of course I was. I never set foot outside. I mean, so there were a bunch of cats whining to do business with me. I thought he had whales lined up, so we're... Now he's got cats too? I never seen that young kid before. I believe the witness' last name was important, huh? So God, if you could please, Tiger, the court asked you to add that last name to your testimony. Don't let an animal beat you, be a man, Your Honor, and ask him yourself. See about that. December 3rd. Take that. It's the tiger. Let me take a drink. And it's a long day today. Cleaning up. Had to clean up toilet water today at the job. I mean, the water almost splashed onto me too, but luckily it didn't splash onto me, it splashed onto my friend, because he was working there too, and we work at the same job together, me and my friend, we work together. So let's... Yeah, the water splashed onto him because... You see the pump that was connecting the pump that was draining out the water from the pool. Because there was like a pool in the house that had like a bunch of toilet water in it. So we had to clean that up with a pump. And it ended up splashing onto my friend because... The pump, the hose disc was got disconnected, so all the water just got pushed out. It jumped up and hit my, and it splashed onto my friend. Let's see. You claim you didn't know Mr. Glenn Elk, but it appears that Mr. Elk knew you. What? Mr. Elk left this little note on his calendar. He was a tiger, dated December 3rd. December 3rd? That's the day of the murder. So Mr. Tiger, I submit that you did indeed know one Mr. Glenn Elk, because on the very day of the incident you met with him. Bruh, ha 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 ha. Not bad, you is actually not bad. Sorry? I was just messing with you to see how good you were. Hear that, Nick? You said that you're not bad. There's one compliment I can do without, plus he's lying through his teeth. Well, please remember that you're under oath. I should not be tolerated. Just calling me a liar? Is that what you're doing? Ro-ro-ro? So you're saying that you claim to have never seen that kid before, is that true? I said I'm dead serious. You better believe that's the truth. Ha! Then I see that gives me time to enjoy another cup of pure black magic. Time for some more excitement. Get that caffeine flowing. That is why you testified for the court against Tiger. As would you mind indulging the court witness? Never actually met the victim. That's got to be a lie right there. Time I nailed this guy. I ain't no liar. I never met Glenn Elk. There's some lame guy with the same name that wanted to borrow some cash from me. Set a meeting with the guy at my office, Tim the lender. I wait around for him, but ain't never sure. I ain't never even been to that Trebian joint, you see? I see, that all seems perfectly logical. I arranged to meet with the victim, but he didn't show up. I've heard it's pretty hard to keep appointments when you're dead. Very well, you may begin your cross-examination, Mr. Wright. Yes, Your Honor. And I think I got a big deal going down today. I'm gonna make my bus now. I'm gonna have to take the express train. This bill's going straight to you, right? Grr. You got trains? Isn't this like in Los Angeles? We ain't ever showed. I never even been to that Trebian joint use here. Matches used for advertising. Found lying in Tinder Lender. Tiger, is there something you'd like to tell the court about these matches? Matches which we use talking about. Find them in your office at Tinder Lender. They're from that restaurant. What? You never really been to Trebian before. What's the book of the restaurant's matches doing on your desk? You've been stooping around my stuff now, too, wise guy? Oh, you my ball and chain, ain't no bra controlling me. Man, that's how we do it in Phoenix, right? We snoop around. We don't get a warrant or anything. We just snoop around. I guess like we own the place or something. Order, well, witness. I think it's time you start telling us the truth, don't you? Sorry, I'm terribly sorry, forgive me. I ain't no pussycat. I don't go back on what I said. Okay, I was at the joint that day. What? But this is good, alright? I might have been there, but I still never met that kid. Now he's changing his mind? Shouldn't get like poetry charts like Armstrong did? Well, well. Looks like an order just came in for another testimony. I'm this close to proving it was him. He did meet Glen Oak that day. He did put poison in the coffee, must have. I was supposed to meet with the kid at the restaurant that afternoon. When I opened the door to the joint, I saw one ugly scene. Guy was laid out over the table, stiff as concrete. I figured if the place wasn't hot already, it was gonna be, so I split. Heard the cop sirens on my way back, and I went straight back to my office. I see. They actually meet with him in the end, then. Oh, Mr. Wright, you cross-examination, please. Yes, Your Honor. Oh, yeah. I wait around here any longer, I ain't even gonna make the normal express. No more stupid questions. Ha. Huh. No problem. Anytime should I press you on something irrelevant, I'll see pays a penalty. Well, Mr. God, that's my job. Your job is to slam that little hammer of yours and call a guilty verdict. So do it. Yes, sir. Special Express ain't cheap, right? So, just so you know, since you used paying. Oh man, doesn't the rule of law mean anything around here? That's the most to meet with the kid at the restaurant that afternoon. Door to the joint, so one ugly scene. I mean, let's see what else did I do at work today. I also smashed some wood, like, I broke some wood. I took doors down and I smashed some wood from the walls, because there was like wooden shelves on the walls. So I had to smash those down. Victor's testimony. You're something of a lone collecting pro, aren't you, Mr. Tiger? No one escapes Tiger's clutches. No, I'm something of a lie detecting pro. And no excuse to finish his clutches. Think this time I got something straight. Was this try a new line of irrelevant questions? These are the floor plans to the crime scene. You say you were standing at the entrance, Mr. Tiger? When did your field of vision have covered an area something like this? Indeed, the victim witness will have a clear view of the victim's seat. Isn't that what I just said? I saw the back of the kid's head. Fortunately for you, that is not possible. Who would think back, you remember that between each of the tables is a tall partition. Why, that's true. And look at the plants again, the truth is painfully obvious. When you enter the field of vision, and it comes from walking in, and it's here. Oh man, he's so, he's really sweating right now. So from the entrance of the tree, you couldn't have seen the victim's seat. But you didn't see the victim that day because you met with him. Wrong, have you forgotten the old man's testimony yesterday? The victim was alone at his table. But the defense just proved that point to be moot. The victim witnessed by Mr. Creel was not Glenn Ellis by a fate. What? I want to have Mr. Creel falsely testify. You really look real clear posed as the victim may have just acted as charade. That will do, and this trial has gone on long enough without the obvious question being answered. Exactly was this real killer who impersonated the victim? Say the killer murdered Glenn Elk. They impersonated his victim and performed for Victor Curio. In that case, Mr. Rabb revealed the identity of this criminal to the court. I'll just stop it right here. Thanks for watching, everybody. Take care, and I'll see you guys next time.